This is Prithviraj, and I'm here to talk to you about my second Hindi film, Aurangzeb, and answer whatever questions you have ready. And for all my friends and fans and lovers from South India, you know, you might have seen me promoting a lot of films in a lot of ways, but you and I know that this is the first time we are getting to talk to each other on a live web chat. So here I am in India's third biggest YouTube channel, the YRF YouTube channel. And this is about Aurangzeb. 17th of May, you are a king or nothing. So getting to the questions that we have. Eklavya Anil Kumar says, Yahoo! And okay, Yahoo! Bhargav Punera says, here we go, yes, here we go. Hi to all those who have told. Hi, hello. Lionhearts 11 says, waiting for you. The Lionheart is actually used to be my Twitter handle. I'm not active on Twitter anymore. Benjamin Kurubala Maliyekal, well, hi Benjamin. So hi to all those who have said hi. And Prithvi Fans Network says, keep all your questions ready. That's right. Lionheart 11 again says, I'm just waiting for your Aurangzeb release and Mumbai Police release in Dubai. Any idea when Mumbai Police is releasing in Dubai? Yes, Mumbai Police, which is my last Malayalam release, should be releasing in a week's time in Dubai. Sanjeev Nambiya says, hello. Hi Sanjeev. Ashish Rai Jain, who has asked me, what motivates you to continue working in movies in different languages? Well, you know, I've always believed that as an actor, what matters is that you get to enact. And movies, cinema as such, I strongly believe is a medium that should not be categorized on linguistic parameters. And the best thing that can happen to an actor is to be able to grow beyond these borders that languages will you know, construct for him. I was very lucky in that respect, because I started off in Malayalam. By the time I was about 3-4 years into my Malayalam industry experience, I was offered my first Tamil film. Then I went on to do a Telugu film. Then of course I did Aiya, and now I'm talking to you about my second Hindi film. So it's fantastic for an actor to know that, you know, you get to work in so many different languages, and somewhere down the line people start accepting you as somebody who belongs from that region, you know, somebody who the audience will no longer question his nativity. For me, Aurangzeb in that respect is a very, very important film, because in my first Hindi film I had the liberty of playing a South Indian. In Aiya, Surya, the character that I played, was a South Indian. In Aurangzeb I'm not. In Aurangzeb I play a police officer in Gurgaon. So, you know, I don't have the liberty of actually saying to myself that, right, I'm playing a South Indian, so I can speak Hindi the way I want to, and, you know, I can just be myself. And that brings me to another fact, that the biggest challenge for me, for Aurangzeb, was to get my Hindi diction right. And I spent a good 6 months with a wonderful diction tutor called Vikas Kumar, who spent a lot of time in getting my Hindi right. And in fact, today when people from Yashraj see the film and they call me up and say, your Hindi is very good in the film, all credit should go to Vikas. You know, if it was not for him, I don't think I could have pulled off this Haryanvi cop very well. Anyway, coming back to the question, what motivates me is good cinema. You know, where good cinema will find me, I will go there. You know, if the next brilliant script that I listen to happens to be from Tulu, you know, I might as well be acting in a Tulu film. For me, all that matters is that I continue being part of good cinema. And it's just been the search for interesting scripts and films that I believe will make, you know, engrossing, entertaining watch, that has taken me from one language to the other. So now I'm hoping and keeping my fingers crossed that good scripts and good cinema will find me in Bollywood as well. There is a question from Meera's Love, which states that sources state that Aurangzeb is a remake of the 1978 film Trishul. Any comments on that? Yes, I have comments on that, because Aurangzeb is in no way a remake of Trishul or any film for that matter. I know that a lot of people are drawing comparisons to to Trishul and Dawn and a few other films, but Aurangzeb is a very, very original story. I understand that these comparisons are being drawn partly because of these, the two brothers, and then from whatever little you've made out from the trailers, where you already, I guess, know that, you know, it's about one guy who looks an identical twin replacing the other guy, you know. But that's where it stops. From there on, Aurangzeb has got nothing to do with Dawn or Trishul. The film is actually a very emotional, intense drama. Although there is a lot of action and there is a lot of, you know, it's the structure of the film is very much that of a crime thriller, but that is very underlying. What comes through, at least when I watch the film, is relationships and, you know, what happens between the characters. So in that sense, it's a very intense drama. So no, Meera, if that is your name, Aurangzeb has got nothing to do with the 1978 classic Trishul. Kyathi Madan says, what are the differences in South Indian and Hindi film industry according to you? The language, you know, pretty much that's it. I know that a lot of people have asked me, you know, we've heard South Indian cinema is very professional and Bollywood is not. I would love to hold on to that and say yes, that's not the case. At least the two Hindi films that I've been part of have been very, very professionally done. In fact, I've in my career, I think two films that I have spent the least amount of time shooting in the past couple of years have been my two Hindi films, because most of the Malayalam and Tamil films these days go on for 70 to 80 days. Both my Hindi films were shot for lesser number of days than that. So even with respect to pace of working and the way things are done, I think very much Hindi is now, Indian cinema as such is now, you know, getting into a very corporate way of doing things, which sort of makes it all very universal. So apart from the language that the actors speak, I really can't spot a difference. But there is a difference. There is a difference once the film releases, because obviously you know that Bollywood is by far the largest stage in our country. So I am assuming that 10 times the number of people will see a Hindi film than a Malayalam film. So that is a big draw for me as an actor. You know, as a performer, you always want more number of people to see your performance. As an actor, you obviously want to be, you know, acting in films that you will know, you know that maximum number of people will get to see. So for me, the biggest draw that Bollywood holds is that, is the fact that Aurangzeb, I know, will be seen by way more people than what a typical Malayalam or Tamil film of mine will be seen by. So that's a big draw, and I'm hoping that Aurangzeb is equally well received in North and in the Southern parts of India. Darpan Jain asked me, was it difficult to put on weight and forgo the toned body which we saw in Aiya? Good question, actually, because when I said yes to Aurangzeb, I was very buffed up and you know, quite the bodybuilder types. And when you see the film, you will understand that Aurangzeb is a very, very real film. The entire effort behind the film has been to make everything seem real, try and make the characters look real. Nowhere in the film will you see the so-called cinematic cliches, or, you know, nowhere in the film will you see a cinema cop. So my brief from Atul Sabarwal, the director of the film, was very, very simple. He told me, you need to look real. You need to look like this guy could actually exist. So obviously I wanted to slim down and look like a very no-nonsense guy. And, you know, obviously Arya Fogart in Aurangzeb is a very fit police officer. But he's not the guy who, you know, has a whey protein shake every 3 hours and spends 4 hours in the gym, which I was doing for Aiya. So obviously I had to lose weight and slim down. But then that's the investment that an actor has to make. Because whatever said and done, however brilliant an actor you might be, the first connect that somebody who watches the film will make with an actor is your appearance, how you appear on screen. So yeah, I mean, it's not easy, but I'm beginning to get used to it now, because over the last few years I've done drastic stuff with my physicality for various films. Because just before Aiya, I was playing a 55-year-old doctor in a film, and then I lost weight for Aiya. Then I'm I put on muscle for Aya, then I lost weight for Aurangzeb. So yeah, these things keep happening, but no, it's not advisable and it's not easy if that's what you want to know.